Welcome to this video for the CTS60 class where students will learn how to use the software package called PowerPoint. Another name for this is presentation graphics. Many people just know it as slideshow software. You've probably seen this in many situations before, whether it's in a classroom as a student or maybe something personal you have done or possibly a friend or a loved one has done. The first project in the textbook is called Creating and Editing a Presentation with Clipart. This is part one in several videos, so that the video will not be too long for students to download. Basically, I would suggest that you save your file after watching the video so you don't lose the work. And when you see the result in the book, which consists of five slides, which I will show you right now, you should not attempt to do these slides by yourself by just looking at the front page of the book. If you do that, you may make some mistakes that you would not normally make because there are some accountability factors in the grading, dealing with whether you have the correct font, the correct kind of slide, the correct design, etc. So just go through the book's directions. You do that, of course, by looking at the red circles with the numbers in them, as I've indicated right here. Look at the screen captures that show what should be on your screen when you do each step or series of steps. And of course, communicate with your instructor if you have additional questions. What you also want to do before you do this slide show is I suggest you go ahead and download the pictures for clip art that sometimes they're called that are associated with the project. Do that ahead of time so it will save you some trouble later. You may have to download these from the internet, and if you do that, you follow the video that I have on Blackboard that shows you how to download videos from your book. And if you go to the inside front cover of your book, there's a website called cengage.com/ct/student download that will help you with that. You also might have an instructor that has provided these clip arts for you on Blackboard so that you can use them. But get that prepared before you begin this particular lesson. So having said this, we'll go straight to the lesson in the book in the PowerPoint section. If you go to PowerPoint page number 4, it will give you the directions for starting PowerPoint, very similar to those directions for starting Word. Click the Start button. There are lots of ways to do this, and many of you know these steps. Do it whatever way you want to. If you have a Microsoft PowerPoint 2010 on there, you can click it. If not, you can go to All Programs in Windows 7, find the Microsoft Office window or folder rather, the yellow folder. Scroll up and down if you need to get to it. And then find PowerPoint in the alphabetical list. There it is right there. And you'll get a new version of PowerPoint to start with. You'll end up with a new screen that looks very similar to this one. The ribbon at the top of the screen has the same structure as that in Word, except you may have some different options involved because this is a different type of software package. We start off, pardon me, in page 5 in choosing a design from the ribbon here at the top. To do that, I click the Design tab. This is at the bottom of page 5 in your book. And we'll choose the More button if necessary. Here are the slide designs, and if you just hover over them with your mouse, your designs will change in the main window. If you click the little arrow right here at the bottom right-hand corner, that is the More button, which will give you additional options to what you already have. And you're looking for something according to page 6 of PowerPoint called the Oil theme. The More button was done in step 2. The Oil theme is kind of an orange looking one. The double A, by the way, that you see right there stands for alphabet. It's talking about text. So if I just hover over these, I think for the most part they're in alphabetical order. There's the oil theme right there. And just click that to select it. And that will give you a general theme for your slides. We'll start out with a title slide. From a design perspective, that's a good thing to do. So at the bottom of page 7, you're going to click the label that says click to add title. And when you click there, the font basically is set up for you already. That's just a placeholder for text that you will put in. And on page 8, step number 2 with the red circle says to type it is, and even though we're doing, it seems like it's all caps, of course the first letter of each word is a little taller cap than the others. It is easy being green. And I don't have to press the enter key. If I press the enter key by accident, what will happen, it just gives that little space there. You can backspace or you can undo if you make that mistake, because a lot of times it's a habit to press the enter key. When we go over to page 9, we'll click the label at the bottom that says click to add subtitle. And when you click that, it gives you another text box to type in replacement information. and we'll type the phrase saving energy at home. There is a spell check in PowerPoint. If you end up having difficulties, you can go through and make sure the spelling is correct. And then we don't press the enter key, and I apologize for my throat during this recording. Let's go ahead and select saving energy at home by looking at PowerPoint page 10 to select a paragraph. You can select this the typical way by dragging your mouse across. You can also do something called a triple click, three mouse clicks in a row, whatever way works for you to select the paragraph. I'm going to italicize it by going to page 11, and with that text selected, you'll move over and choose the Home tab, since I'm currently in Design, and we'll choose the italics or the I letter that we did back in Word as well, and that will make it become italics. You can change the font size while you have it selected, and you can do that by changing the font size up here in the ribbon, as it says, to 24 point, or you can actually go into the text, and if you can get that little miniature tag in there, it's mini toolbar. I just don't use it very much. You can also sometimes get that over here. You don't have to use the mini bar. As long as you can get the 24 in there, that's totally fine. So it makes it a little bit larger. On page 12, we're going to do something a little different also by selecting the word, very similar to what you do in Microsoft Word. And to select the word, I can just move over to the word green, which is the one we want to do from page 12. You can double-click the word or you can drag to select it. And then we'll change the text color from page 13 to a green color. And again, you can use the mini toolbar if you want to. That's sort of shadow hidden right there. Notice that it's the same as the toolbar up in the Home design, just a smaller version, just a capsule of it. So you can use either one. And when I want to change the color of words, I'm always going to use the letter A, which stands for alphabet. So I choose the A that's got the red font color underscored. And if I click that, I get the choices of colors. This big swatch right here that sometimes it's called. And if you choose green, you basically just go to the bottom row and just use the standard green color. And if I hover over it, of course, the text will automatically change to the color I'm hovered over. And I'll choose green by just clicking on it. And if you want to deselect the word, just click away from it, and it will deselect it. We can actually save the presentation at this point according to page 14. And again, remember that the book defaults right now to a flash drive. And if you have one, let your instructor help you out if you need it. If you need to be shown how to save it specifically to your drive, you can back it up to Dropbox later if you want to also. I'm going to click File and choose Save As because I get the choice right here of choosing where I want to save it. I'm saving mine on my desktop, so I'll find the word desktop in this list on the left. When I click Desktop, it's going to default to the first sentence as my file name, and that first sentence in my first slide says it is easy being green. We're going to change the name to what the book says in step 2 on page 14, saving energy. And once this is saved, just click and make sure you're in the right location where you want it, and just click the save button and it will save. I will stop at this point just to make sure that you're uncracked securely with the beginning of this PowerPoint presentation. If you need any help additionally, contact your instructor or replay the video as you need to.